Hello guys, the Exposing Ghosts. Like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Today's talk will be Emmanuel Exposed. Subtitle, it's gonna burn in hell with Billy. Luke 6:26, warn to you, all men speak well of you, for so did the father to the false prophets. Luke 16:15, and he said to them, ye are they which justify yourself for men, but God know your heart, for that which your heart stain among men is abomination in the sight of God. Emmanuel, well spoken of, and your heart stain among men. The attack that happened against him by the Muslim was wrong, and Islam is a cult of personality that designed the damn souls to hell. Emmanuel's life was spared today, but this man needs to repent. Because I'm about to play a clip and expose him for denying the gospel in front of people. So here goes.
Some denominations in Christendom, they say once you receive Jesus as Lord and Savior, you're saved forever. This is a false teaching. Be careful. It is not biblical at all. Just because you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, come into my heart, come into my life, come into my spirit, come into my being. That's it, you're saved no matter what you do. Hello? Anybody home? No way.
Emmanuel obliquely denied the gospel in front of people. The only way to heaven is to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ for salvation. And I have verses to prove this here to go best or wrong. Let's get started. John 3:15, that whosoever believe in him should not perish but have eternal life. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. John 3:18, he that believe on him is not condemned, but he that believe not is condemned already, because he had not believed in the name of the only begotten son of God. John 3:36, he that believeth on the Son hath everlasting life, and he that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abide on him. Christ makes it plain and clear, the only way to heaven is by believing in him, and no other, and that's it. And if Emmanuel doesn't repent of his false belief system, and believe on Lord Jesus Christ for salvation, he's going to go to hell, he's going to burn in hell, he's going to be tormented in hell. The Apostle Paul warns about people like this who pervert the gospel of Christ. Galatians 1:6-9, I marvel that ye are so soon removed from him that call you into the grace of Christ unto another gospel, which is not another, but there be some that trouble you and will pervert the gospel of Christ. But though we or angel from him preach any other gospel to you than that which we have preached unto you, let him be accursed. As we said before, so I say now again, if any man preach any other gospel to you than ye have received, let him be accursed. Now, let me get to another person that I want to talk about in the video. His name is Billy. Who is Billy? Everybody might be wondering. Well, Billy is someone who trusted in his filthy rag to save him, which were his works. And his works damn him. I'm about to play a clip about Billy and show Emmanuel audience that if he doesn't believe in the Lord Jesus Christ for salvation, he's going to hell. And he will have no one but to blame but himself, because God gave it all. He gives the only begotten Son. So, let's get this clip on the road and get started.
am I?
You are at the Great White Throne Judgment.
How you know my name?
I just know that when your name is called to approach his throne, I'll be bound to acknowledge him as the ability. For it is written in his word, Philippians 2:9-11, wherefore God also has highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of things in heaven and things in earth and things in earth under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. So you will have no choice but to bow to him.
Thanks for the heads up.
You may approach my throne, Billy.
I'm glad to be in his presence. God is giving me a chance to come to heaven, and I can't wait to enter.
Why should I let you into the kingdom of heaven, Billy?
Lord, I have done many works for you in my life. I repented of my sins. I went to church daily to fellowship. I gave my life to you. I was baptized in your name, and I persevere in my faith to the end, Lord.
Stop it. Right there. All I heard from you is your boasting and your filthy rags to get into heaven, as it is written in Isaiah 64:6, but we are all as an unclean thing, and all our righteousnesses are as filthy rags, and we all do fade as a leaf, and our iniquities, like the wind, have taken us away, Ephesians 2:9, out of works, lest any man should boast. That's all you have showed me is your filthy rags, and you are boasting in yourself and what you did to get into my kingdom.
But Lord, I thought I needed good works to please you to go to heaven, Lord. I gave all the credit to you, Lord.
Since all you have is works, you will be judged according to your works, as it is written in Revelation 20:12-15. And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God, and the books were opened. And another book was opened, which is the book of life, and the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books, according to their works. And the sea gave up the dead which were in it, and death and hell delivered up the dead which were in them. And they were judged every man according to their works. Death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. Let me see if your name is written in my book of life.
I know I'm in there. I did too much for Christ in my life.
Your name is not found written in the book of life, Billy.
No way. I did all of that for you, and I'm not there.
Since you are not written in my book of life, you will be judged by your good works and evil works, Billy. And you did good works, which you will get credit for them. And you have a lot of evil works, which is sin. And sin will not be allowed in my kingdom, Billy.
But Lord, I have repented of all my sins. I had no sins on my record.
First, who James 2:10, for whosoever shall keep the whole law, and yet offend in one point, he is guilty of all. James 2:11-4, he that said, do not commit adultery, said also, do not kill. Now if thou commit no adultery, yet if thou kill, thou art become a transgressor of the law. 1 John 1:8, if we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. 1 John 1:10, if we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. Philippians 4, by the deeds of the law, there shall no flesh be justified in his sight. By the law is the knowledge of sin. Galatians 5, for I testify again to every man that is circumcised, that he is a debtor to do the whole law. Here, Titus, does become of no effect unto you. Whosoever of you are justified by the law, ye are fallen from grace. Jonah 3, and then God saw their works, that they turned from their evil way. And God repented of the evil that he had said that he would do unto them, and he did it not.
Oh my, I didn't know, Lord.
You knew Billy, and you was calling me a liar at the same time, and you have false view of repentance. I didn't repent of no sins, Billy, but change my mind, and you believe that repentment turned from sins. So you will be calling me a sinner, too. You had many people in your lifetime to tell you the truth about me, but you blew them off, because you was blinded by the world and Satan. For it is written 2 Corinthians 4, in whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. 2 Timothy 4, for the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned unto fables. You knew about me, but you choose to not accept me and my work I did on the cross for you. You went after false doctrine instead of my doctrine.
But Lord, I really did obey you and everything about you and the gospel.
You still want to give me excuses. Now, I'm about to tell you what you should have done to get into heaven. For it is written 1 Corinthians 15:1, for moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel which I preached unto you, which also ye have received, and wherein ye stand, by which also ye are saved, if ye keep in memory what I preached unto you. Unless ye have believed in vain, for I delivered unto you first of all that which I also received, how that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the Scriptures, Acts 16:31, and brought them out, and said, Sirs, what must I do to be saved? And they said, Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved in thy house.
I knew the gospel, Lord. I did everything the gospel said.
But Billy, you never believe, if you have believed in me and what I did for you. You wouldn't be here now boasting in your filthy rags. And again it is written, Then for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that everyone may receive the things done in his body, according to that he hath done, whether it be good or bad. You did good works, but they were not required for salvation. The works you were showing to me to get to heaven should have been done once you were saved. And again it is written, Ephesians 2:10, for we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them. You should have done them works after he was born again, but instead you are giving all the credit to yourself instead of me.
Lord, you are absolutely right. I knew better. But can I get another chance?
No, you had your chance on earth. My father gave everything for you to go to heaven, but you disobey him and fail to do his will. And again, it is written in John 3:15-18, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. But he that believeth on him is not condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. Esteemed but not as the offense, so also is the free gift. For if through the offense of one many be dead, much more the grace of God, and the gift by grace, which is by one man, Jesus Christ, hath abounded unto many, for the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord, for saved through faith. And that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God. Romans 11:6, and if by grace, then is it no more of works. Otherwise, grace is no more grace. But if it be of works, then it is no more grace. For the Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to us, Lord, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. My father gave his all to you, Billy, but you didn't want to repent of your unbelief in me, but instead trust in your filthy rags to save you instead. And now is time for your sentencing, and you are sentenced to death for your sins, and you will join your father Satan in the lake of fire because you have committed a sin that I can never forgive for. It is written in 2:31-32, wherefore I say unto you, all manner of sin and blasphemy shall be forgiven unto men, but the blasphemy against the Holy Ghost shall not be forgiven unto men. And whosoever speaketh a word against the Son of Man, it shall be forgiven. But whosoever speaketh against the Holy Ghost, it shall not be forgiven him, neither in this world, neither in the world to come.
Lord, I'm really, really sorry, Lord. I will do anything to repent and turn to you.
Why are you calling me Lord and fail to do as I say? And again, Billy, it is written, John Sice, 40, and this is the will of him that sent me, that everyone which seeth the Son and believeth on him may have everlasting life. And I will raise him up at the last. 5:21, for he hath made him to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. He failed to do my father's will, and I was made your sins, Billy. You never believe in me to be forgiven, and you will die in your sins. For it is written, John 8:24, I said therefore unto you, that you shall die in your sins. For if you believe not that I am he, you shall die in your sins.
Please let me do his will. I'll do anything to be forgiven again.
Billy, again, it is written in my word, Jews web and woe unto them, for they have gone in the way of Cain, and ran greedily after the error of Balaam for reward, and perished in the gainsaying of Kor, Hebrews 11. Then for by faith Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts, and by it he being dead yet speaketh, for it in process of time came to pass, that Cain brought of the fruit of the ground an offering unto the Lord. Genesis 4:5, but unto Cain and to his offering he had not respect. And Cain was very wroth, and his countenance fell. Billy, you wanted to do things Cain's way. You wanted to give me your filthy rags, which are your
was, but I know that you will still let me repent.
I will never forgive you for blasphemy of the Holy Spirit. Since you rejected me on earth, I would have gave it to you. But instead, you wanted to work your way into heaven, instead of believing in me and my work on the cross. For it is written in Ephesians 1:13, and you also trusted, after that ye heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, in whom also after that ye believed, ye were sealed with that Holy Spirit of promise. You heard the truth in your life, but you wanted to be Aggron and do things your way.
Please give it to me now so that I can join you.
Stop begging me to let you in, for it's time for me to depart from my presence. And you knew this chapter in Ephesians verse really well, for it is written. Matthew 21:23-21. Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. As you can clearly see, Billy, this is you. You call me Lord, Lord, and you fail to do my Father's will, which I just told you. 22 many will say to me, in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name, and in thy name have cast out devils? And in thy name done many wonderful works. This is you also, Billy. You are boasting in your works, and you was judged by them works, for they are filthy, and they are your sins, and you committed the unforgivable sin, which I will never forgive you of. 23, and then will I profess unto them, I never knew you, depart from me, ye that work iniquity. And I just gave you your sinities, Billy, because I never knew you, because you never believed in me. And now you must depart from me, ye that work iniquity, into hell, prepare for the devils and his angels, and you will be forever damned with your father Satan. Take him away, bond him in foot, and thrown him into outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth.
Please, I beg of you, don't let me go into that place of horrible torment. I just left hell, and now I'm going to a lake of fire, which I see hell in it, and it's worse than hell. Help me, someone, anyone. Hey, aren't you the angel I saw earlier?
Yes, I am. Now you must go away from the presence of our God and go into the lake of fire with the rest of the damned that rejected him. You had your chance, and you blew it. Get away from me.
Help me, somebody, anybody. Let me out here. Please, Lord, let me out so I can join you.
Billy went to hell for never trusting in Christ to save him, but he instead trusted in 50 rags, which ultimately damned him. It's going to be a sad day for many people who are like Martin Emmanuel if he don't repent of his false belief system, which would damn him to hell, and believe on Lord Jesus Christ for salvation. Now, that's all I got to say. May God bless.